I used to make a lot of cheesy action movies when I was a kid using my dad's Super 8 movie camera. So I've got a bunch of old movies laying around, and I decided to mail some in to this company that does digital transfers. This company called Legacy Digital Productions is the one I went with. And they did a good job, but you mail in your old Super 8 film and you get it back and a flash drive with the film transferred in MP4 format to it. And there's different choices on their website. You can choose 1080p or 720. You can have it put on a DVD instead of a flash drive if you prefer. And they can even transfer slides or VCR tape too. So I'll put a link in the description to their website and you can check them out. I did a little bit of research before I went with them. I know Walmart does it too. They outsource it to some other company and I was afraid to go with them, so I had read some good things about this Legacy Digital Productions and they did a good job. And you can only expect so much from Super 8 film that's 34 years old, so. So I'm going to show you one of the movies I made. It's like a 13-minute movie right after this introduction. And it's been re-rendered a few times because I wanted to add some sound effects and music and do some narration. And then I had to upload it to YouTube and that reduced the quality a little bit more. So the actual quality is a hair better than what you're going to see here in a minute. But yeah, this movie was filmed in the fall of 1986. I was 17 years old and I'm 50 years old now. But yeah, you kids today, you don't know how well you've got it. If you like making movies, you can just use your smartphone and do as many takes as you want, not have to use expensive film. And the editing software out there is crazy good. I mean, when I edited back in the day, I edited with scissors and tape, scotch tape, to do a hard edit. And then the other, like, soft edits were done in camera, so the whole movies would be filmed sequentially. Do the first scene, the first take. No, there'd be like one take. And then do the second scene, do this third scene. And you try to avoid having to do an edit where you'd have to break out the scissors, after you sent it off and got developed and it'd come back. Because every time you do a hard edit, usually you'd see it. It'd be like residue where the tape was on the film, so you could tell it was edited there. So, and you'll see that in the transition. And I think there's little blue lines in some places, but I was pretty happy with the way this turned out. And like I say, I'm gonna show you this movie, and if you got some Super 8 movies in the attic or somewhere, don't just let them rot away. Get them transferred to digital so you can have them to keep forever or until the world ends. How about that? So let's take a look at this old movie I made. Okay, here we go. The name of this movie was called The Stealing Scandal. It was one of many movies I made back in the day, just for fun with my dad's Super 8 camera. There's my little brother there. He usually played the main character. But this movie was filmed back in the fall of '86. So there's my brother just programming some type of code. He's trying to make a robot out of this car or something. There's my old Atari 1200 XL computer and my Legend 880 printer. Anybody remember that? The dot matrix printer that used squares instead of dots. But anyway, he is typing in some code, printing it out, trying to see if he can program this car to get him to go do stuff for him. So he thinks he's got the program right. There's the power button, got the wires all hooked up. And he presses the button, but nothing happens. By the way, there's that remote control car. I used to be into those back in the day. Had several top of the line remote control cars. But anyway, he can't seem to get it working. It's not doing anything. So he all of a sudden comes up with an idea. He goes back and looks at the program, and he sees where he left out a line of code. So he thinks he's got it now. Enters that in, hooks it back up, hits the power button, and the car gets electricity and takes off on its own. So he's very happy with himself that he got it working. Calls the car back. The car is now an official robot. He can give it commands, make it do stuff. Puts it back on the table, and he hooks the wires back up. And now I believe he is about to install some weaponry onto the car. Notice that guy in the background? That was a mistake. He got caught in the frame there. He's one of the actors in the movie coming up. But anyway, he's hooking up the cannon and hooking up the laser guns to the car. So he's ready to go attack something. Not sure what. I guess we'll find out here in a minute. So, let's see what happens next. He sits down, and I believe he's going to program the car to make it, give it an errand for it to run. So he's typing in, what, get me a skateboard? So the car has a new mission. Go get him a skateboard. Car takes off. And there it goes, down the driveway, and through the streets of the neighborhood, looking for a skateboard. It's zipping through the streets, trying to hunt a skateboard down. And eventually, what do you know? There's a dude right there on a skateboard. Perfect. So car is going to come up on him and I think suggests that he gives him the skateboard or else. And wow, he gets blown up and the car comes up, backs up, uses its special electrical power to create a string that connects to the skateboard and takes off down the road with the skateboard to go take it back to his master. His master is sitting there eagerly awaiting the arrival, wondering what the hell's taking so long. And yes, there it is. It's finally coming around the corner. So he's really happy and excited that his invention has worked. And there's a Vision skateboard. Anybody remember the Vision skateboards? I guess they still make them. I don't know. They were popular back in the 80s. So he's happy with the result of his first mission. So he's given the car a second mission. Go get him a soccer ball. Let's plug it back in. Give it some power. And on its way to its second mission. Notice a two-toned station wagon in the background. How about that? Okay. The car. Notice this car on the right. As we were filming, I remember this car actually came down the street. I was trying to avoid not running into it. I was the one usually driving the car, the remote control car. So he comes up to this other dude in the neighborhood. Has a soccer ball. So car will try to get it from him. And so he shoots a laser or his electrical current at him, and that shocks the guy and kills him, electrocutes him, he's dead. The car backs up, shoots an electrical beam to the ball, and again, string magically appears and There he goes, takes the ball back to my brother. And mission two looks like it's successful. So my brother undoes the string, gives the thumbs up sign, and I believe he's gonna give the car one last mission. And this time it's getting more serious. He wants the car to go get him some money. So there's our cat, Snowball. This is the cat. This was an interesting scene here. We put the camera, the Super 8 camera, on top of the car and filmed it point of view with some duct tape. And there I am on the right. There's me at 17 years old. That's my good friend on the left. And I'm about to purchase a bike from him that I saw on Craigslist. No, there was no internet actually back at this time, or no World Wide Web, so. But I'm just buying this bike from him. There we go, it's a nice sale, and I'm just gonna ride my bike home to my house and show off my friends my new bike. But unfortunately, I don't make it home. I get shot down and killed by this strange car running through the neighborhood. So the car comes up to my good friend, sees the money, and takes a couple laser beam shots at him, knocks him down, money falls out, shoots a laser, electrical current at the money, gets that, and takes off to take, oh my god, but hold on, the guy didn't die this time, he only got injured, and it just so happens that his car is right there running. So he jumps in his car and takes off after the remote control robot car. So I remember this scene, I was like, my friend was driving and I was sitting in the passenger seat controlling the remote control car as we were driving. That was kind of tricky. And so now my brother is decided to close up shop for the day. He's gonna put away the computer and just sort of wait for the car to get the money, and I guess that'll be it for today, and they'll try to get some more stuff tomorrow. Oh, folding up the card table, get the office chair, put that away, but oh, okay, here comes the car, and my friend has followed him to his house, so now he knows where he lives. So he watches the car go back to the backyard, and he takes off. So where is he going? I don't know. We'll see. So let's see. The robot car comes back with the money. A good $100 or so. My brother's very happy with that. Tucks the money into his pocket. And what's he gonna do here? Picks the car up. And so later he's just out in the yard playing with his new toys. He's got a new skateboard, he's got a new soccer ball, money. Now he's just having a good old time. But hold on, oh shit, this can't be good. Here comes my friend, and it looks like he's got something in his hand. It looks like it's a bazooka. It's like he went home and got him a bazooka and then came back. So this doesn't look like it's gonna end well. We'll see, but looks like he's slowly trudging back to the backyard to face the guy that stole his money. And let's see what happens next. Looks like he's gonna, I hope he doesn't fire that bazooka. It looks like he is. Blew up the guy's my brother's table. So that's like the warning shot, I guess. But my brother sicks the car on him, and the car fires some lasers. But oh, look, he's got a mirror in his jacket. And the laser just bounces off and blows the car up. So that's that. Takes another bazooka shot at my brother, and looks like he just barely missed him. And as you can see him in the background, he throws his bazooka down and hides behind a tree. So they're both hiding behind trees. And let's see here. My brother is wondering where he went. He comes out from his hiding spot looking for him. He doesn't know where he went. Oh, there he is. And he pulls out a grenade, of all things. And he pulls the pin, and it looks like my brother got a grenade in the back. So that had to hurt a little bit. But he's still alive, and he gets up, a little wounded. Looks like he's got a little bit of a backache. And he's still looking for him, standing out there in the open. Let's see, where could he be? Where is he? Oh, there he is. Springs down from somewhere and punches him in the face, and then he's got a nice big kitchen knife and throws that at him, barely missing his head. He demands his money back, and he gets it. And one last kick for good measure, and then you would think he would walk away, but no, he stops. What is this all about? He stops. My brother sees an opportunity. Okay, I got a knife. Oh, but hold on. He's got a gigantic bomb in his jacket. And just as my brother throws the knife, oh, he bowls this bomb right to him. And yeah, I think my brother kind of got blown up there. So I think that's kind of the end of the movie, if I remember correctly. And yep, he just gets in the car and drives off, and everything is happily ever after, I guess, right? So there's that. The end.